Hello friends, good morning. This is Professor Atul Phirke, Associate Professor at GS College of Commerce, Wardha. Welcome to you all during the e-learning test series for the academic session 2020-21. It is presumed that you all are promoted for the BCom second year, and during this COVID-19 period, as it is uncertain that when the lectures will be started, when you will be enrolled into the college, and when your physical classroom tutorials will be started, as this is uncertain and it is unpredictable for the upcoming 2 or 3 months, that's why we are made an alternative to start a tutorial lecture through these e-learning resources. The subject allotted to me from the college administration for the BCom second year third semester is financial accounting. You will have in all 6 subjects, wherein 2 subjects will be of language and 4 subjects will be of comms. Prior to BCom second year, in BCom first year, you have already learned in semester 1 financial accounting and in semester 2 statistics. So as during the 3-year 6-semester syllabus, this is the second year for which the financial accounting is being taught, therefore during the syllabus the title is given as financial accounting 2. You may go through the syllabus given by the RTM Nagpur University Nagpur in the direction, but take into consideration that you are referring the direction of the recent syllabus. Continuous amendments are taken by the RTM Nagpur University, that is the governing body and the institution which is taking care of our curriculum. Presuming that the same curriculum will be followed for the year 2020-21, as this is the very first lecture on your class, we are considering the syllabus recommended by the university for the third semester for 100 marks. Our subject is total 100, will be of 100 marks. Theory examination will be of 80 marks, that is the written examination for 3 of us, and 20 marks are internal assessment marks. So 80 marks written test, the entire syllabus for each and every subject is divided into 4 units. Each unit carry equal marks. As the 80 marks subject is equally divided into 4 units, each and every unit will carry 20 marks. Briefly, we will discuss about the syllabus. As during the e-learning contents, information will be disseminated by the faculty itself, but at the same time, for assignment purpose and for homework purpose, you may refer to the open access resources at your own destiny. For that purpose, what is included in our syllabus and what is not there into the syllabus, for that purpose, in order to have a clear-cut guidelines, I will narrate or briefly discuss about the syllabus which is to be taken into consideration for the upcoming 90 days. Unit number 1. Each unit contains only 1 chapter. Unit number 1 having a first chapter. This is from special type of accounting, that is consignment account. And each unit is having a weightage of 20 marks. Later on, I will discuss about the paper pattern recommended by the university. First unit is of consignment account consisting of 20 marks, wherein you will have to take into consideration and you will have to go through the concept of consignment, the parties involved into the consignment, the document to be sent by the consigner and the consignee, that is pro forma invoice, account sale, difference between the traditional sale and the consignment, accounting treatment of the consignment, valuation of the unsold stock, valuation of the normal loss, abnormal loss, all these are to be taken into consideration under this particular chapter. This chapter will have theoretical concept as well as practical concept. How many marks are allocated for the theory and how many marks are allocated for the practical problems, numerical problems, that will be taken into consideration into the paper pattern. Second unit consisting of chapter 2 is again another branch of accounting, special type of accounting, which is considered as a branch account. And again, the second unit will also carry equal marks of 20. Compulsory question will be there for 16 marks along with the choice, and last question will be of the 4 marks. Under branch account, basically there are 3 types of branches: dependent branch, independent branch, and foreign branch. So under this topic, for theoretical concept, you will have to take into care of types of branches, accounting for the branches. Only for dependent branch and independent branch, it is clearly mentioned in the syllabus that excluding foreign branch. Earlier foreign branch was there into the syllabus, but as there is a problem and as year by year, month by year, there is a fluctuation into the foreign currencies and Indian currencies. So at what rate the foreign currencies are to be converted into the rupee currencies, it is unpredictable, and there may be flexibility into that particular currency rate. Therefore, foreign branch is excluded from our syllabus, and we will concentrate only on 2 type of branches, that is dependent branch and independent branch, and accounting for the branches. That is the coverage of unit number 2. The next unit is unit number 3. Serially chapter number 3, wherein company accounts came into existence. The third unit, third chapter, is the flotation of company. And its capital structure. As per the text word used into the syllabus, it is flotation of company, that is the process for formation of the company, specifically the joint stock company. And capital structure. During the stage of formation, there is a vertebrate stage. That stage consists of raising the capital. From which source the capital is raised? Whether it is an equity source, own capital, or whether it is a debt, that is a borrowed capital. And among the equity share capital, what is the procedure for accounting for issue of shares? It is restricted to only equity share. That may be applicable to equity share, or that may be applicable to preference share. But the procedure for accounting of share, oversubscription of the share, undersubscription of the share, different types of issue, that is issue at par, issue at premium, issue at discount, procedure for accounting for forfeiture of the share, reissue of the forfeited share, and amount to be transferred to capital reserve. All this portion is covered into this particular unit. If I may not be wrong, I think this particular topic is already covered into your board syllabus of the class 12. You are having the certain basic knowledge, and you have already gone through about 80% or 70% of the task on this particular topic, but certain advanced level of questionnaire, it will be considered into the BCom syllabus, undergraduate syllabus. This topic will also carry equal marks of 20. And the last topic, which is again related to the company, topic number 4, is liquidation of the company. Will carry 20 marks. In the third topic, we have taken care of formation of the company, and into the last topic, unit number 4, it is the liquidation of the company. As it is a company created by the law, it is not easy to shut down the company or to close down the company. There is particular legislation, there is particular rules and regulation which is to be followed for closing down the company. So what are the rules and regulations for the liquidation of the company? What are the circumstances wherein the company went into the liquidation? Who will take care of all the modalities of the liquidation? That is called a person called as liquidator, third person will be appointed. What is the remuneration to be payable to the liquidator? And what are the finance statements to be prepared under the process of liquidation? All these contents are included into unit number 4. So students, this is about the whole syllabus to be covered into the upcoming 90 days. Into the next upcoming video, we will discuss about the paper pattern of the university for these 4 units. Thank you.